Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Roy, working as an assistant professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Topic covered here is writing a grammar topic of syntax analysis. In the previous video, I considered the transformation that are useful for rewriting the grammar so that they become suitable for top-down parsing, such as writing a grammar for given non-deterministic finite automata, eliminating an ambiguity from given grammar, and identifying the non-context-free languages. In this video, I am going to cover the topic eliminate left recursion from given grammar and left factor the grammar for given example. Learning outcome: at the end of the session, students will be able to eliminate left recursion from a given grammar and left factor the grammar for the given example. Elimination of left recursion. A grammar is left recursive if it has a non-terminal A such that there is a derivation A derives A alpha in one or more steps for some string alpha. In left recursive grammar, the leftmost symbol on the right side of the production is the same as the non-terminal on the left side of the production. Top-down parsing method cannot handle the left recursive grammar, so a transformation that eliminates left recursion is needed. Immediate left recursion. A left recursive production can be eliminated by rewriting the offending production. Consider a non-terminal A with two production. A derives A alpha or the beta, where beta does not start with A. Here, we replace the A production by A derives beta A dash and A dash derives alpha A dash or the epsilon, which is an equivalent grammar. No matter how many A productions there are, we can eliminate the immediate left recursion from them by the following technique. First, we group the A productions as A derives A alpha 1 or A alpha 2 and so on up to A alpha m or beta 1 or beta 2 and so on up to beta n, where beta 1, beta 2 up to beta n do not start with A. Then we replace the A productions by A derives beta A 1 dash or beta 2 A dash and so on up to beta n A dash, and A dash derives alpha 1 A dash or alpha 2 A dash and so on up to alpha m A dash or epsilon, which is an equivalent grammar. Immediate left recursion example. So consider this example. E derives E plus T or T. T derives T star F or F. F derives ID or in parenthesis E. Eliminating the immediate left recursion to the production for E and then for T, we obtain the following grammar. E derives T E dash. E dash derives plus T E dash or epsilon. T derives F T dash. T dash derives star F T dash or epsilon. And F derives I D or in the parenthesis E. A grammar cannot be immediately left recursive, but it still can be left recursive. By just eliminating the immediate left recursion, we may not get a grammar which is not a left recursive. Consider the grammar. S derives AA or B. A derives SC or D. This grammar is not immediately left recursive, but it is still left recursive. Consider the example. S derives AA, derives SCA, or A derives SC, derives AAC, causes to a left recursion. So, we have to eliminate all the left recursions from our grammar. Eliminating the left recursion algorithm. Input: grammar G with no cycles or the epsilon production. Output: an equivalent grammar with no left recursion. So the method: apply the following algorithm given below in the flowchart to the grammar G. The resulting non-left recursive grammar may have epsilon production. First step: arrange non-terminals in some order, that is A1, A2 up to AN. For I is equal to 1 to n, do. Second for loop, for j is equal to 1 to i minus 1, do. Replace each production of the form AI derives AJ gamma by the production AI derives alpha 1 gamma or alpha 2 gamma and so on up to alpha k gamma, where AJ derives alpha 1 or alpha 2 and so on up to alpha k. Next, end of the first for loop. Eliminate the immediate left recursion among the AI production and then end of the second for loop. Example, S derives AA or B, A derives AC or SD or F. Now first step, that is order of the non-terminal, that is S and the A. For S, we do not enter the inner loop as there is no immediate left recursion in the S. For A, replace A derives SD with A derives AAD or BD. So A derives AC or AAD or BD. And after eliminating the immediate left recursion in A, A derives BD A dash or FA dash, and A dash derives CA dash or AD A dash or the epsilon. An equivalent grammar which is not left recursive is given below. Till now, we consider what is left recursive grammar and how to eliminate the left recursion from the given grammar. Now, pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, eliminate left recursion from the following grammar. I hope all of you have completed this activity. So, the question was, eliminate left recursion from the following grammar production, S derives SAB or SCD or the E. So after eliminating the left recursion from the grammar, we get S derives ES dash and S dash derives AB S dash or CD S dash or the epsilon. Left factoring is a grammar transformation that is useful for producing a grammar suitable for predictive passing. The basic idea is that when it is not clear which of the two alternative production to use to expand a non-terminal A, we may be able to rewrite the A production to defer the decision until we have seen enough of the input to make the right choice. Consider the example, that is statement derives if expression then statement else statement or if expression then statement. When we see if, we cannot immediately tell which production rule to choose to rewrite the statement in the derivation. In general, if A derives alpha beta 1 or the alpha beta 2 are the two productions and the input begins with a non-empty string derived from A, we do not know whether to expand A to beta 1 or the beta 2. However, we may defer the decision by expanding A to alpha A dash. Then, after seeing the input derived from the A, we expand A dash to beta 1 or to beta 2. That is, the left factored, the original production becomes A derives alpha A dash and A dash derives beta 1 or the beta 2. For each non-terminal A with the two or more production rule with a common non-empty prefix, A derives alpha beta 1 or the alpha beta 2 and so on up to alpha beta n or the gamma 1, gamma 2 and so on up to gamma m. Convert it into A derives alpha A dash or gamma 1 or gamma 2 and so on up to gamma m and A dash derives beta 1 or beta 2 and so on up to beta n. Consider the example. The following grammar abstract the dangling S problem. Statement derives if expression then statement else statement or if expression then statement. This grammar is written as S derives IETS or IETSES or A and E derives B. Here I, T and E stands for if, then and else. E and S for expression and statement. So left factor this, so the grammar becomes S derives IETS S dash or A, S dash derives ES or epsilon and E derives B. This is the second example of left factoring the grammar, and same is explained here. This is the reference. Thank you.